Good morning. I would like to welcome you to another ICT lesson. Today I want to discuss comparison operators. The comparison operators are used to compare numbers. If you want to know if one number is greater or equal to another, or one number is less or equal to another, you use comparison operators. These operators are also used in mathematics, and you can find if x is equal to y or x is less than y and such. Even in computers, it is the same symbols which we are using. The first one is what we call equal sign. Equal sign, you know it very well from our early kindergarten mathematics. It is being used, and this is used to compare if one thing is equal to another. For example, if I write here, check if x is equal to y, it means I'm using this operator to compare if what is in x is equal to what is in y. And in MS Excel, for example, it is the same sign which is being used. The next symbol I want us to do is called greater than sign. Greater than sign. And this one looks like this. And it is used to confirm if a certain number is greater than a certain number. And if you want to write it, you just compare. For example, I can use x, check if x is greater than y. Check if x is greater than y. Here, when the computer sees this symbol, it will return true or false. If whatever is in x is greater than y, it will be true. And if whatever is in x is less than y, it will be false. Because the condition is check if what is in x is greater than what is y. And you tell us whether it is true or false. The next comparison operator is called greater than and equal to, and equal to. This one is also very important, and it is written like this, greater or equal to. It has two symbols, one for the greater than sign. The other symbol after that one is the one for equal sign. This one is used to compare two things. For example, I can say check if max is greater or equal to 50. Is greater or equal to 50. For example, in exams, you want to know whether somebody got a pass or a fail. Probably you do such comparisons. So in this case, if max code will be 50 or it is more than 50, then the result will be true. But if, for example, we have 49 as max here, 49 is less than 50. So it will not turn to be true, it will be false. Then the other symbol which we normally use is called less than sign. We have less than sign. And that one is written like that. This one we compare if the first number is less than the second number. For example, if I have max, I can compare it with 50. Here, I'm asking myself, What is in max? Is it less than 50? If it is less than 50, then what will be returned is true. And if whatever is in max is more than 50, then it will be false. So this one is checking if something is less than a certain value, in this case 50. The last one I wanted to check and share with you is called less than and equal. Less than and equal to. And this one is written like this, less than sign, then equal sign. So this one, you can check here. It is, we are asking ourselves, is a certain number less or equal to a certain number? For example, I can have here a max. Then I ask myself, is this code max less or equal to 49? Okay. In this case, maybe it is an exam, and if you score 49 or below, you are supposed to get a fail. So we are asking ourselves, can you check what is in max? Is it less than or equal to 49? If it is less than 49 or equal to 49, the result will be true. And if, for example, somebody scored 50, 50 is not equal to 49 and 50 is not less than 49. And in that case, the result will be false. So these are the main operators which we use when we are using especially if function in Excel or in any other programming calculations. I will go ahead and show you how they are used in MS Excel. I will start my file here, open it in MS Excel, and you can see from this list I have a list of students, and these students scored some points here, and I want to apply the rule which says 50 and above will be pass, and below 50, anything below 50 will be a fail. So this is the rule I want to apply, and in that case I'm going to use if function in Excel and a certain comparison operator. In this case I will use equal to or above 50, or above 50 and equal to 50 operator. I will, in other words, I'm telling you, I will use this operator, greater or equal to 50, in my if function. So in this case, I am using the operator greater or equal to. Let me go ahead and show you. So the first thing, in if function, you put equal sign like that. After putting equal sign, you type the word if, then the menu will suggest, then you just double click it like this, then you pick your points, the number you want to compare with 50, just click it like that. Then I am asking myself, is what is in C3 greater or equal to 50? Okay, and in this case we know 34 is not greater or equal to 50, so we expect a fail there. After testing the value, we are going to put a comma and write what should be written in the cell if the testing or the comparison was true. So in this case, if what is in C3 is greater or equal to 50, we will put pass. and put a comma. Then I'll put in quotes what it should be shown on the cell if the value of testing is false. If we compare C3 and if it is greater or than less than 50, then we get it is a false, then it will write what is in position 3 in this bracket. In that case, it will write fail. Then I'm going to close the quote and I'm going to close the bracket. Then I will just press enter, and you can see it is true, 34 is less than 50, and it is not also equal to 50, and we got a fail grade. So I will just go here and pull down the formula handle, and you can see the calculations were done automatically and computer determined the grades. And this is how we use comparison operators together with the if function to determine the results of calculations in MS Excel. Thanks so much for participating. See you next time. Bye bye.